perfectly aligned shelves, everything labeled and in its assigned place.
Imagine if I could just have a moment where everything was perfectly tucked away, there wasn't a thing to do, every garbage can was emptied, and every shirt was perfectly folded, there wasn't even a sock in the laundry basket.
It would be great to have that, but then real life invades and we realize our homes can't achieve that Pinterest perfect organization that we see on TV. So we talked to Patty Morrissey, an organizing and lifestyle expert and the founder of Clear and Cultivate, about how we can declutter our lives without losing our minds. First, we've got to break down why we're so obsessed with organization.
In 2019, there was Tidying Up with Marie Kondo, which was one of the most successful shows. Now there's The Home Edit. We're drawn to this desire for control, this need for structure.
Especially right now when we feel like we don't have control over a lot of our lives. Binging shows about organizing can make us feel like we've got it all together.
So it's great when they're a source of inspiration. It's not great when you watch them and then feel shame or bad about yourself because your life doesn't look that way.
So next, let's figure out how you can actually benefit from organizing. Patty says that one way to ensure you're profiting from picking up is to ask yourself why you're tidying.
I have to be mindful of, am I using it as a drug of choice? Am I using it as an escape mechanism? Am I using it to avoid something else more important that I should be dealing with? Or is it something that's building and enhancing my life?
And Patty also says you should be organizing with intention.
And that ultimately starts with, what's your vision for your ideal lifestyle? And we all have different degrees of how tidy or messy we can tolerate things.
So depending on where you want to be in your life is how you should look at organizing. And that doesn't necessarily mean that everything has to be put away in its perfect place.
I have a pull-up bar hanging from my bedroom doorway right now, and I don't put it away. It's not particularly attractive, but what it is an environmental trigger to remind me to take little exercise breaks throughout the day. It's a reminder to step away from the computer and stretch a little bit.
So finally, that brings us to how to start organizing.
The big mistake that people make is they get overly excited and overly ambitious, kind of aggressive. You know, you watch the show and it's midnight and then you're like, that's it. And you start grabbing garbage bags. You're gonna get exhausted. You're gonna upset your whole family. So slow down.
Figure out what space you really want to begin with, and don't be afraid to take it room by room, day by day.
You can reinvent yourself simply by changing your environment.
We're organizing your life on the top of the list.